If you like this course and would like to learn more, then do consider our course on Udemy Django Database ORM Mastery Level 1. The actual thumbnail might change over time, but just look for Created by Very Academy. There is a link in the video description to the course. That is always going to give you the best price for the course. In the previous tutorial, we learned how to insert data into a single table with a many-to-many relationship. So now we're going to explore the SQL code to give us a better understanding of what's happening behind the scenes to actually insert data into a table when we're working with a many-to-many relationship. Hello, my name is Xander. Welcome to the ORM Mastery course, Level 1 for Beginners. This tutorial is part of the YouTube edition playlist, Django Database ORM Mastery. You can find the link to this playlist in the video description, where you'll find all the tutorials associated to this course. If you would like to follow along step by step, you can download our base Django project, Codebase 1. There is a link in the video description to that code. Now, if you are not familiar with Django and how to start a new Django project, there is also a video guide on how to download and start the project. Again, there is a link in the video description to that. So really, you need to have seen the previous tutorial to better understand this tutorial, but I'll quickly recap. So here we have the set of tables that we're working with in the previous tutorial. We have the automatically generated link table between the product and category, because we have a many-to-many relationship defined in our product model here between the product and the category table. We've seen from the previous tutorial that we needed to make sure that there was an entry in the category and the product table before we could then go ahead. Because we're using foreign keys here in the link table here, we needed to make sure that there was objects or entries in the category and product tables first. And then we went ahead and we used a piece of code to then associate a product to multiple or single categories. So let's go ahead and tidy everything up if you have been following from the previous tutorial. So I'm just going to go ahead and import. Oh, actually, I need to get into my shell. Apologies. Okay, so let's just go ahead and import all the models that we might need. And then we'll go ahead and just delete all the data. Seems like a good idea. Now, one thing is missing here, which is the link table. Notice that we're not deleting anything from the link table if you were coming from the previous tutorial. But that doesn't necessarily matter because of the foreign key constraints there. So if I show the table here, in actual fact, everything has now been removed from the product category table, so the link table. So if you remember a few tutorials back, I mentioned about the behavior when we deleted data that was connected to a table with a foreign key. So behind the scenes, what's happened here is that when we deleted the product and the categories, the data was automatically deleted from the inventory product category table. Okay, so just to reiterate there, so if you go into models and you look for a foreign key, we can see that it has a on delete option. So that was what I was referring to previously in a couple of tutorials back. So our link table simply just has delete here. So it would just delete anything if the corresponding items, objects in the database were deleted. So what we're going to do here is, first of all, just inspect what Django creates in terms of the SQL for this operation, and then we'll go ahead and build our own. So we are going to need to bring in the connection and reset query for this, so I'll go ahead and do that. So we're going to need the connection and also the reset queries, so we bring that into our terminal here so we can access them. Right, so I've executed that and we can now access them, of course. Right, so let's just go ahead and reset the queries. Okay, should we add that in? Right, so first of all then, let's go ahead and just add a new item, an entry into the product table, for example. So no big deal here. We'll just utilize the code we had in the previous tutorial. I'll just move this so we can see. And I will wrap that so we can see it all. So yeah, this is just code, copied and pasted. Remember, all the code is in a markdown file associated to each tutorial, so you'll be able to download this code. Now, because we've already utilized this code in the previous tutorial, I'm just copying and pasting this in. So go ahead, feel as though you can type this out, of course, if you want to practice, but I'm just going to type this in, save that. So we now have a new product instance in our database, and I'm going to need a new category, of course. So I just grab one of those. So grab that and add a new category. Right, so that was two queries. So let's have, or shall we inspect those queries? So we can do that obviously by utilizing the connection that we brought in. So let's say connection dot queries. So that's going to show us our two queries that we just run. So we have one query here, is our insert query. And I'm just looking for the second one. So that's our first query, inserting into the product table. And this is our second query where we inserted. So it said select from inventory time. And then we tried to insert. Remember here, we're using a save. So first of all, it tried to insert, and then it went ahead and inserted. Yeah, it tried to do update first, I think. Where are we? Okay, so we tried to select first. Because we're using MPTT. Okay, we can ignore that. So yeah, we just went ahead and we inserted into the database. So those are the two queries that we just generated from inserting the two products. So don't worry if you don't understand them. The fact is, two queries were created. That's not really the important component here. So now we want to build that connection, don't we, between these two products. And then that will populate that link table. And then that will create the relationship between the two tables so that we can then further query and return data in regards to categories associated with products and products associated with categories. Right, so let's go ahead now and run an X, which is our product. And then we're going to use the category field in the product table to refer to the many-to-many table. And then we're going to say add to then specify the instances that we want to connect our product to in the category table. And then we can pass in a category, which is now in Y. So let's first of all reset our queries. Let's just go ahead and reset the queries. And we'll run this query and then we'll inspect it. So there's our query. So we've now added to our product category table. You can see we've made that relationship now. So let's go back and have a look at the query. So I press up, there we go. And there we go. So that was the query that was generated. Now, notice what's happened here. It's really simple. We've just created an insert. So all we've done here is we've inserted into the product category table, which is the link table, into product ID and category ID 7 and 3. That was the IDs of the two instances, objects that we inserted and saved into the corresponding tables. So to summarize, in order to actually save data in this table and build the relationship, we need an insert for product, we need an insert statement for category, and we need a very simple insert statement for this table. So there isn't really any magic here at all. It's literally just three insert statements. Where the development really needs to take place here is to understand how to manage your data from those different sources and then prepare them to be presented and then inserted into the database. And we will, in this course, look at some of those more practical elements. But for now, we're just looking at the underpinning skills. So I do apologize if you want a little bit more there in terms of how to actually work with your kind of real data from a real project. We will get to that, but here we're looking and focusing on the underpinning skills. So to replicate what the Django ORM is providing, we simply just need to create three insert statements. So one for the product, one for the category, and then one for the link table. So let's just go ahead and we'll delete all the data from our tables, right? Okay, so we're starting fresh again. So let's just create these queries. Now, of course, there's quite a few different fields here. So again, have a look at the code markdown file associated to this tutorial. And let's just go ahead and utilize this code rather than you typing it out at this point, because we're just running insert statements again. So this will be for the inventory product table. Hopefully this works. There we go. So we've created a product. So let's go ahead now and create a new category. Now notice here that because we're using MPTT, that is providing behind the scenes a few more different fields that we don't need to know is out of scope here. But there's a few different fields here, so that's representing that there. So let's go ahead and add that into that table. So we should have two new instances in our table. Just double check that by going into our table product. We've got one product now we've just added and one category. So that has an ID of 4 and 8. Okay, so we've just added that manually utilizing our SQL code here. So let's now think about now adding into the third table. Well, it's really simple, isn't it? Because we know that there are two fields in this table. So there needs to be two values passed in. And we now know the category is ID 4. And we now know that the product is ID 8, so 4 and 8. So we just need to line that up here. Yours might be slightly different, of course. So 4 and 8. There we go. So we should now be able to build that connection. And the problem is here, I probably did it the wrong way around, didn't I? Apologies. Right, product. So the product was 8. Okay, that's why. Wow. So the other way around. There we go. So hopefully this now will take shape. And there we go. So if we now go into the link table, show the table, we now have that connection there. If you're still wondering why we need this table, that will make a little bit more sense and come together once we start querying our database, once we actually start gathering data from the database, because we're going to essentially use this relationship that we're generating here to traverse through the table and grab data from either table and so on. So it builds relationships. That's essentially what's happening here. We're relating the product table to the category table through this table here. And that's going to allow us to retrieve data in different ways that we're going to always require in our application.